Interesting. First, let's make it look more scientific. Let me explain what these results mean exactly. For example, using the old Kaplan's, the column will typically fall when I try to put the fourth block of planks. Of course, columns will sometimes be smaller or taller, but over the 16 old Kaplan columns, the mean value of the maximum stable height was 2.88. The process was repeated for each type of planks to get the final values. But why are the old Kaplan's so bad? Their length is uneven, probably because they were bought over several years. This creates column defects, like leaning shown by the left picture or instability shown by the right picture. It is hard to build with such planks. For example, when I was building this tower, I started using old Kaplan at some point, but I had to stop after only two layers and deconstruct as the structure became too unstable. Let's move on to the T-caps. They showed a different type of defect shown here. This is problematic when using planks upright. City blocks are a discontinued product with which I also have a lot of experience. They are hard to build with. The same can be said about the old Kaplan's. By comparison, the Kaplan's I use for my videos are much better. So it seems that the column score is an excellent indicator of plank quality. All the reviewed planks have 5-3-1 length ratios, meaning that the width is 3 times the thickness, and the length is 5 times the width. Or is it? To measure the exact ratios, I used this simple method. I aligned 2 stacks of planks, for example one along the thickness and one along the length. This gives me the true ratio, for example here, 29 thickness for 2 lengths. An ideal ratio would be 30 thickness instead, so the length is short by 3.3%. This method can be very precise. For the Kaplan, the length to width ratio was measured at 5.02. Here are all the results summarized. It is the Kiva planks which shows the best results. But how do these imperfect ratios impact construction? Let me give you an example. For the temple project, when we had to bridge the columns with the middle structure, we had to manage a height difference of half a Kaplan thickness. In this case, we used a lot of coins. In summary, this table shows the column score and price of each type of plank. Let me conclude with a few pictures of what can be done with Kaplan. I cannot stress it enough. To be able to build things like this, good quality planks are required.